In this video, I'm going to walk you step by step through the process of setting up your audio interface for the very first time. I'll show you how to connect your interface to the DAW in your computer. I'll show you how to connect speakers to your interface, and I'll demonstrate how to record a microphone and a guitar. I'll use a Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 interface for this demonstration, but the steps in this video will apply to nearly every interface on the market. If you're new to this channel, I'm Kyle. You can learn audio production online by checking out the weekly videos I post to audiouniversityonline.com. If that sounds interesting, subscribe below. When you open the Focusrite Scarlett 2i2, you find the interface itself and the USB cable for connecting it to your computer. The first step is to connect the interface to your computer using the included cable. You may need to download the most up-to-date driver for your interface. You can find this easily with a quick search. In this case, I'll search Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 drivers. The first result is a link to the manufacturer's downloads page that lets me easily search for software related to my interface. The Focusrite Control app is the only download available for the Focusrite Scarlett 2i2. However, some interfaces will require the most up-to-date driver to work properly with your computer. If you're using a new interface or picking up an old interface for the first time in a long time, it's worth a quick search to see if there are any updates to the current driver on your computer. If you want all of the programs on your computer to play audio out through the interface, select the speaker symbol in the corner of your screen. For Mac users, search Sound in System Preferences. This will allow you to control which speakers are used for audio from web browsers or music applications. Select your interface as the audio output device. You may need to additionally select the audio interface as the input and output device of the software on your computer called a Digital Audio Workstation, or DAW. This process is very similar in most DAWs. I'm going to show you in Reaper, but it's probably a similar process no matter which software you're using. In Reaper, I choose Options in the top menu bar and then Preferences. In some software, Preferences can be found in the Edit drop-down menu. You want to set the audio hardware for the DAW to the audio interface you're using. The next step is to create two tracks in your DAW. You can usually find this option under Track or Add in the menu bar. I'm adding two mono tracks so that the inputs to the audio interface will be recorded separately. On one of the mono tracks, I'll select Input 1, and on the other mono track, I'll select Input 2. If I configured it so that both physical inputs, input 1 and 2, on the audio interface, recorded to a single stereo track, I would probably end up with one input on the left and one input on the right, and I don't want that. That's why I'm choosing to select two mono tracks and configure it so that input 1 is routed to track 1 and input 2 is routed to track 2. Now that we've connected the audio interface to the computer, it's time to get audio in and out of the audio interface. The first thing I'll do is configure the output devices, my headphones and my speakers. If you just want to use headphones, simply plug them into the headphone jack on the front panel. This small knob controls the output level of the headphones. This larger monitor knob controls the output level of the quarter-inch outputs on the back panel. I can use a quarter-inch TRS cable to make a balanced connection to both of my speakers. At this stage, you can test the audio output by playing audio from the web browser or another program on your computer, such as a YouTube video. Now it's time to record. I'll use input 1 to record a Shure SM58 as a vocal microphone, and I'll connect a condenser microphone to input 2 for recording acoustic guitar. If your interface has a mic level, line level switch, switch it to mic level. The condenser microphone needs phantom power, but the SM58 doesn't need phantom power. There is only one switch on the 2i2 that turns on phantom power to both inputs, but don't worry, phantom power won't damage a dynamic microphone like the SM58. Before recording a microphone, make sure to turn the monitor knob all the way down to prevent a feedback loop from forming between the microphone and your speakers. You'll want to use headphones for this step. Inside your DAW, you'll need to arm the tracks that you plan to record. This can be done by selecting the red circle next to the track. Once both circles are illuminated, start to increase the preamp gain knob on each microphone while singing or playing the guitar. Turn it up until the meters on the screen peak at no higher than negative 12 decibels full scale, or dBFS. Aim for the signal level to average at about minus 18 dBFS. You may notice a significant delay when listening through the DAW. This can make playing impossible. The 2i2 has a cool feature called Direct Monitor, which routes the microphones directly to the headphones with very low latency. I'll switch this function on so that I can hear the microphones through the headphones. If you're using the Direct Monitor feature on your interface, mute the tracks within the DAW so that you don't hear an echo. Once you've set your levels and you see the signal on each channel meter in the DAW, it's time to press record. After you record, you should see waveforms like this. Rewind the track, turn off the record arm on each channel, and press play. If your audio device settings in the DAW are correct, you should hear the recording playing through your speakers. If you don't hear your recording playing through your speakers at this point, you should go back to step 2 and make sure that the audio output device for your DAW is set properly. Okay, so I've got a basic guitar and vocal recording. Let's say I want to go back and overdub an electric guitar on top of these two tracks. First, I'll make a new track. Let's select the input of this track as input 1 on the interface. I'll unplug the old microphones and turn off phantom power. Plug in my electric guitar directly into input 1 with a 1/4-inch TS instrument cable. I'll make sure to set the line instrument switch to instrument. The process is the same as recording a microphone from this point. This time, I'll only arm the track I'm recording to, which is track 3. I want to offer you a free home studio checklist to make sure you've got everything you need to make professional sounding recordings at home. You can find this checklist absolutely free at audiouniversityonline.com/free-home-studio-checklist. If you got value out of this video, hit the like button, check out the next video that's coming up, and for more content like this, subscribe to Audio University.